Good day, everyone. Welcome to our online class. This is Ma'am Teresa Tubal. Join me to enjoy mathematics. This is our activity overview. This is an arithmetic sequence. Instruction: answer yes if the below numbers are in arithmetic sequence. Otherwise, answer no. Question number 1. This is an example of arithmetic sequence. 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, and 4.5. Correct. The answer is yes, because the common difference from first up to the last term is 0.5. Number 2. 2, 8, 32, 128, 512. Is this an example of arithmetic sequence? No. Correct. Because there's no common difference for question number 2. How about number 3? 0.7, 0.9, 1.1, 1.3, and 1.5. Do you think this is an example of arithmetic sequence? Correct. The answer is yes, because the common difference from first up to the last term is equal to 0.2. Question number 4. Is this an example of arithmetic sequence? 5, 1, 4 over 5, 4 over 3, and 4 over 7? No, correct. Because there is no common difference. Question number 5. In the sequence 11, 16, 21, 26, and 31, is this an example of arithmetic sequence? Any idea? Correct. The answer is yes, because the common difference is equal to 5. What's next? What is the next 2 terms? Okay, instruction, find the next 2 terms of the arithmetic sequence. Question number 1. Find the next 2 terms of the arithmetic sequence 2, 7, and 12. What do you think is the next 2 terms? Correct. The next 2 terms is equal to 17 and 22, because the common difference is equal to 5. How to get 5? By means of subtracting the second term by the first term. So 7 minus 2, that is equal to 5. Question number 2. Find the next 2 terms of the arithmetic sequence 2, 0, and negative 2. What do you think is the next 2 terms? Correct. The answer is equal to negative 4 and negative 6, because the common difference is equal to negative 2. Again, 0 minus 2, that is equal to negative 2. So the pattern from first up to the last term is equal to negative 2. Question number 3. Find the next 2 terms of the arithmetic sequence, negative 1, 3, and 7. Correct. The answer is equal to 11 and 15, because the common difference is equal to 4. How to get 4? By means of subtracting the second term by the first term. So 3 minus negative 1, or that becomes 3 plus 1, that is equal to 4. Or you may use the third term minus the second term, so 7 minus 3, that is also equal to 4. So the pattern is equal to 4. Question number 4. Find the next two terms for 12, 16, and 20. Correct. The answer is equal to 24 and 28. So the common difference is equal to 4. So second term minus the first term. So 16 minus 12, the answer is 4. So the common difference is equal to 4. Question number 5 in the sequence 8, 11, and 14. What is the next two terms? Correct. The answer is 17 and 20. Because the common difference is 3. How to get 3? Again, 11 minus 8, that is equal to positive 3. Let's do it. Let us recall the system of linear equation using elimination method. We need to eliminate x or y. How to eliminate x or y? It should be same number to eliminate x or eliminate y. So if this is the case, this is equation 1 and equation 2, we need to eliminate x because we have the same number. So if we subtract, that becomes 2 minus 3. That is equal to negative y, and then cancel x because 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0x. And then 18 minus 22, that is equal to negative 4. To solve for y, divide both sides by negative 1. So it means the value for y is equal to 4. Let us substitute the value for y that is equal to 4 to equation 1 or equation 2. So if we replace the value of y by 4, so that becomes x plus 2 times 4 and then copy 18. And then multiply 2 times 4, that becomes 8, and then the rest copy x, copy 18. Combine like terms, that becomes bring down x, bring down 18, positive 8. Change the sign, that becomes negative 8. So 18 minus 8, the answer x is equal to positive 10. How about if we use the equation 2? Again, replace the value of y by positive 4. So that becomes x plus 3, replace y by 4, equals bring down 22. Solve for this, so 3 times 4, that becomes 12. So copy x, copy positive 22. Combine like terms, so bring down x, bring down 22, and then change the sign of positive 12 going to right, so that becomes negative 12. So 22 minus 12, the value for x is equal to positive 10. So it means any equation you may use to solve for x. The formula for the arithmetic sequence is a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus the quantity n minus 1 times d. What if the first term is unknown? So you may use the same method in the arithmetic sequence. And then we need to apply the system of linear equation using elimination method. Find the first term of the arithmetic sequence. If the fifth term is equal to 15, the 19th term is equal to 57. Find the first term. We need to use the formula, and then we need to replace the value of the fifth term by the formula. So that becomes fifth term is equal to a sub 1 plus the value for n is 5. 5 minus 1, that is equal to 40, equals 15. How about the 19th term? So a sub 19 is equal to a sub 1 plus the value for n is 19. So 19 minus 1, that is equal to 18d, equals 57. We need to eliminate the first term because we have the same number. If we subtract, that becomes 4 minus 18. That becomes negative 14d, and then cancel the first term because 1 minus 1, that is 0 first term, equals 15 minus 57, subtract, and then copy the big sign, so that becomes negative 42. So divide both sides by negative 14 to solve for the value of D. So negative 14 that divided by negative 14 is 1D. And then negative 42 divided by negative 14, the value for D is equal to positive 3. Substitute the value for D to any equation. So let us replace the value for D to the first equation. So that becomes, bring down A sub 1, replace the value of D by 3. So 4 times 3 is equal to 15. Next, bring down A sub 1 plus 4 times 3 is 12. Equals 15. Combine like terms so that becomes a sub 1 is equal to 15 minus 12. So the first term is equal to positive 3. Let us try to use the second equation if the answer is also equal to positive 3. So that becomes bring down a sub 1, 18, replace the value of d by positive 3 equals 57. Again, a sub 1, 18 times 3, that is equal to 54, equals 57. Combine like terms, so that becomes a sub 1 is equal to 57 minus 54. So it means in the second equation, we have the same answer. The first term is also equal to positive 3. So we may use any equation you want, equation 1 or equation 2, to solve for the first term. Find the first term of the arithmetic sequence for number 2. 6th term is 25, 12th term is 55. Find the first term. So we need to use the formula. So replace the 6th term. So a sub 6 is equal to a sub 1. The value for n is 6 minus 1, that is equal to 5d, equals 25. In the second equation, a sub 12 is equal to a sub 1 plus the value for n is equal to 12, 12 minus 1, that is equal to 11d, and then 55. Let us eliminate the first term because we have the same number. So if we eliminate, that becomes 5 minus 11 is equal to negative 6d. And then cancel a sub 1 because 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. 25 minus 55, subtract 30, and then copy the big sign, that is equal to negative. To solve for D, divide both sides by negative 6. So negative 6 divided by negative 6, that is equal to D. 30, negative 30 divided by negative 6, that is equal to positive 5. We need to replace the value of D to 5 to any equation to solve for the first term. So if we replace to a sub 6, so that becomes a sub 1 plus copy 5, the common difference is equal to 5, equals 25. So 5 times 5, that is 25. Combine like terms, so that becomes a sub 1, bring down 25, change the sign of 25, that is negative 25. So the first term is equal to 0. How about in a sub 12? So again, replace the value for D, that is equal to positive 5. 11 times 5 is 55, and then the rest, bring down the first term, bring down the 55, and then combine like terms. So bring down A sub 1, bring down 55, change the sign of positive 55, that is negative 55. So the first term is equal to 0. Let us apply what you have learned. Practice exercises. Question number 1. Find the first term given that a sub 4 is equal to negative 10, the fifth term is negative 16, and d is equal to negative 6. A negative 4, b positive 8, c positive 2, and d equals negative 8. I give you 15 seconds. Go! Okay, time's up. What is your answer? Negative 8. Let us try. Sorry, negative 8 is incorrect. Any answer? Correct. The answer is equal to positive 8. Question number 2. Find the first term given that the fifth term is equal to 3, the 10th term is equal to 33. A, negative 21, B, 21, C, 12, D equals negative 12. Go. Okay, time's up. The answer is equal to, correct. The answer is equal to negative 21. Question number 3. Find the first term given that the 10th term is 12, the 21st term is equal to 34. A, 6, B, 9, C, negative 6, D equals negative 9. Go. Okay, time's up. The answer is correct. The answer is equal to negative 6. Question number 4. Find the first term given that the 6th term equals negative 2, the 11th term is negative 17. A, negative 31, B, 31, C, negative 13, D, 13. Go. What is your answer? Correct. The answer is equal to 13. Question number 5. Find the first term given that the 11th term is 2, the 21st term is 22. A, negative 18, B, 18, C, negative 8, D equals to negative 81. Go. Okay, time's up. The answer is equal to correct. The answer is equal to negative 18. So let us see what you have learned. Arithmetic sequence to compute, use the formula a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus the quantity n minus 1 times d. A sub n denotes last term, a sub 1 is first term, n is the number of terms, d is common difference. You may also use this formula using elimination method. Again, example of the arithmetic sequence is 5, 11, 17, and 23. And then the common difference is equal to 6 because 11 minus 5, that is equal to 6. 17 minus 11, that is also equal to 6. So 23 minus 17 is also equal to 6. Any question? I hope you learned a lot. Enjoy learning mathematics! I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.